while you make your opening?
Why not? Why not?
Don't you want to get demonetized?
I don't think I get monetization. You know, I barely make any revenue whatever, and I don't, I don't make any revenue whatsoever. So earlier today, Marvin and I went to the gym, and afterwards we had a little photo shoot, right? Here's a picture up on the screen. It's like a normal doozy thingy, right? And we took that around 7-ish o'clock, and now it's 12:16, right? And I'm starting to edit these photos, right? I'm looking around, I'm like, I'm thirsty. So I go looking for my hydro flask, and I'm like, where the fuck is it? I go up to the area on my bed and in my gym bag, where I last remember putting it, and it wasn't there. Then I go and check my car, it wasn't there either. And I'm like, fuck, where did I put it? I ask Marvin, and he's like, I think I remember you leaving it next to your car. And I was like, fuck. So I started like trying to like find every little piece of information I could like find, and my detective ass found this photo. It's right there. I left it right next to my fucking car. What? Wait, what? No, you can tell me. Dude, just tell me. Dude, you already said it.
What's the point of showing them the actual photo with your camera? When you can just, you know, special effect it.
No, okay, you don't understand. Putting that into the fucking video takes like 15 minutes of my life.
It's a picture.
It takes so much time putting it into the video. Actually, wait, you're right. It's already on my computer.
Exactly.
Big brain. I couldn't think that. Right there in this photo, you can see on the bottom right is the hydro flask. I left it right next to my fucking car. I remember pulling the U-turn and everything to head back. So right now, we're on a rescue mission for this hydro flask. And afterwards, we're getting some Taco Bell. Dude, why would someone pee in it and then not take it? All right. Rescue mission, activate.
Light and use the phone.
Oh, dude. Look at the fucking stars. Yeah. Oh. It's saved right here. Look, you can see a star up there. One single star. Everything else is pretty visible though. Best burrito shot ever.
You put a burrito instead of taco?
Yeah. Alright, so it is 2 days later. I always start up these scenes like fucking putting on my seatbelt and stuff, right? It is Tuesday. I just finished going to the gym. I had my leg session. I actually had my first session with my program. And boy, let me tell you, it's definitely different going on a program than just fucking eyeballing your workout. It's fucking great. I just went to UPS real quick to drop off my Onyx shirt that Kevin gave me. He wants it back, so. No take backsies. I struggled to fit in that gray one regardless. I'm going home right now though. I'm going on a Target run to get some food with Renee, but I'm not gonna film that stuff. Let's see what happens next though. I shit you not. The little fuckers inside that cage grew in one fucking morning. I checked on them this morning, gave them food and stuff, and they're already bigger. I shit you not. Just from like the little 6 hours, 5 hours since I was gone. Oh my goodness, you're so close to the camera. Oh, that's so fucking adorable. You want some camera, little boy? So it is exactly the next day. I got a message from my apartment complex saying that I got a package to pick up today. I'm pretty sure I know exactly what it is. Right now I'm gonna head out to go pick it up. It's probably something for the guinea pig and you guys are gonna like it.
Oh, you're gonna shoot yourself leaving?
Yeah. And then I ended up shot myself putting back in with the box. There was exactly one guinea pig in here. Damn. A little veggie basket for them. It's so fucking cute. This is gonna go in the corner of the little cage and then they get to hide in there. This is an expensive ass looking bottle. It's made out of glass. I'm not sure if you guys could see it. Bam. This goes in here and it floats under the water. That's adorable. A little Playboy toys. Playboy toys? Yikes. It's empty now. Wow. Very nice. For the guinea pigs. Two stickers. Let's get this cage changed or something, whatever the fuck. No way in hell we leaving nobody alive, even suicide, no fuck that. Bobby feeling villainous, he killing us. I'm coming for your man and his lady and even a baby. I'm feeling like I'm chicken, slim shady with rabies. I'm foaming at the mouth, ain't nobody taking me out. Every single rapper in the industry, yeah, they know what I'm about. And I dare you to test me, cause not a single one of you motherfuckers impressed me. And maybe that's a little bit of an exaggeration, but I'm full of innovation. And I'm tired of all of this high school, he's cool, he's not rap shit. Can a single one of you motherfuckers even rap shit? No, this ain't a diss to the game, this is a gas to the flame. Nowadays, everybody saying the same shit's lame. Like a moth to the flame, I'm a real man and killing. Are you feeling lyricism when I'm spilling it? I'm feeling myself. Yeah, yeah, Bobby Bull, he been feeling himself. Man's murder like this can't be good for my health. When I rap like this, do I sound like shit? Well, it don't really matter cause I'm killing this shit. Yeah, I'm killing this shit. Oh yeah, I'm killing this shit. Bobby, how many times you been killing this shit? Find another rhyme, goddamn, nigga shit. Fuck rap, bustle like an addict with a semi-automatic. Who done had it and he ready for anybody to buck back? Hold on, catch a vibe, ain't no way in hell we leaving nobody alive.
Wow, this feels so much wider on camera compared to the other lens. This is my regular kit lens that I fucking abandoned throughout the days. It's 12:12. We're going to the gym right now. The gym closes at 2 o'clock, right? I've had my pre-workout. I have my little breakfast thingy here. A little bit of carbs and a little bit of fats and protein. That's it. Today's my second day. Well, technically third day of my program. My second day is technically the rest day. Today we're going to be hitting chest. I'm just going to bring you guys through it. And I'm actually going to show you guys what exactly I'm doing for my program. Because literally everything is structured the same way. It's just different by week by week. And like you recontinue the cycle for the second week and for the third week. Because 4, 8. Yeah. So we're going to take you guys through my third chest day of my program. See you guys there. I literally raced to get to this fucking railroad intersection. The head of the train is right there. And then, like, it's this fucking long. It got to the fucking crossroad before me, and now that's waiting there. So now I just gotta wait until this fucking train passes. Oh, it ends right there. It's about to be 12:30. I'm gonna have a 1-hour and 30-minute workout for my program. So, I mean, as you guys can see, you know, in the background, you know, I appreciate his efforts and stuff, but does the guy really have to spot him for every single rep? It gets a little annoying, you know? And then plus they were kind of like staring at me during my little bench session. It's a little weird. So first things first, right? What I start off with now for my push session, right? I'll of course get my warm-up sets in, I'll stretch and everything. And then I'll reach my top set of, I believe, 175? Or it could be 85, I could be wrong. I do three working sets of it where I focus on getting an RPE of 9, because depending on what time of day I'm working out and how much I've eaten that day, the amount of reps that I actually am able to like put out will like change just because of those variables. But as long as I know that I'm putting in the effort of an RPE of 9 where I can only do like one rep left for sure, then I know that I'm like putting my muscles around the same amount of stimulus pretty much. Here's my third working set. I did not do as many reps on this set as the other ones. But, you know, it's kind of expected. It's my third set, you know, RPE of 9. And I'm not used to, like, benching that many heavy sets after a while. Here's my second working set. I'm doing 135 for, I believe, an RPE of 8. I do two sets of these. I do these two sets after I do my top sets. Let's see, I could have my notebook here. Here's my other working set of 135. Came out pretty much just as smooth. As you can see, I kind of ended up trying to do it as fast as I could, tried hammering them out. I actually did 165 for my first three working sets and 135 for my second working sets. Of course, the RP of 9 and then the RP of 8. Here I'm doing 103. I try really hard not to bust these out too quickly, but you know, it is kind of lightweight. But since I was towards the end of this little benching section, I was a little bit torn out already. So, with an RPE of 8, I did about like 8 sets, I think, 7 sets. Here's my second working set of 105. That's pretty much how all my push workouts are gonna be. But every week, well, the following push day, right? What's gonna happen is that I'm gonna add one extra working set of my 165 while decreasing the RPE. So I'll be doing four sets of 165, but with an RPE of 8. It might be a little bit more towards the volume side, but I will end up lifting up more weight, like in the long run, because of volume. But I'm not gonna be exerting myself as hard because of the heavy, like, because of the amount of reps that I'll be doing with RPE of 8. Here I already started my military press. I do, or overhead press, whichever you want to call it. I typically, here on my program, I have four sets of overhead press. My first two being of 95, which is 25s per side, with an RPE of 9, same thing as like my bench stuff. These RPEs usually change by week two with overhead press and things like that, just because I consider it a compound here. Here's my second working set. I ended up doing only 3 reps, I believe. Well, no, yeah, written down on paper, I ended up doing 3 reps. One less than the one before. I actually kind of like warming up with overhead press before bench press, but specifically on this day, I remember going to the gym and it was so busy. Like, it's usually never that busy. Like, every other time, well, I'd only gone one other time before that, but like every time I go to this gym, like, it's pretty empty. But this day, for some reason, it was just really packed. I actually didn't end up being able to do everything that I wanted to. Here I'm doing my first working set of 75, which is only 15 per side. I ended up doing 5 reps of RPE of 8. 2 sets is the same amount of reps, actually. But it still ended up feeling like really... burnt out. I couldn't find like my tempo at this point because I was just like really burnt out, and I was like a little like not in the mood because of how busy it was. It was really early. It was 4th of July this day. It was on a Thursday. So I was kind of like a little bit of a temp punch. Oh, you saw right there. I don't know what that set was. I didn't even feel myself properly. All you saw had was a little butt angle. Now here I have a little bit of a physique update. I unfortunately couldn't get the lighting right. I didn't really look at the footage afterwards. But if you can see a little bit, I'm looking a little bit dense, you know? A little bit leaner now too. Today, as of now, like, not too much, but yeah. I'm so much more into this wide depth of view. It looks so much better and nicer, you know? Listen, girl, when you can't even hide it, and it didn't take forever to find it. I was all on my own, almost glad to be alone until love came in on time, on time. So loving is easy.